What's up, guys? It's Randy B, and you know I have to talk a little bit about this Columbus Day. Talk about the lies my teacher taught me. Like, I literally feel betrayed, led astray, bamboozled. I mean, for years, I'm sure I wrote multiple book reports on Christopher Columbus, and he didn't do nothing. I mean, let me not say he didn't do anything. I'm sure it was nice that he brought home jewels and gifts and everything back home and everything. And that was great. I mean, like, give him a raise, maybe. But not a whole day that is not even true, right? And it really shows, it really demonstrates how this world is fully designed to be run by white supremacy. It's like, we don't exist, things don't exist until a white person says they do. And what shocks me is how colonized my mind was, because I knew that there were Native Americans there, right? We all knew that. And we still adopted and accepted the belief wholeheartedly that Christopher Columbus discovered America. That just shows how we really need to check our thinking, okay? But when we know better, we do better. So we're doing better now. A lot of areas have changed it from Christopher Columbus Day to Indigenous Peoples Day, which is much more correct. So let's continue to do better and continue to learn. There are a few things we say in the English language that are actually offensive to Native Americans. One, powwows, no. Calling someone chief, absolutely not. Spirit animals, okay? I know it sounds really nice and we'd like to say someone is our spirit animal, but it's actually offensive. The term Indian, okay? Although that the Native Americans have many organizations and bureaus named with Indian in them, most will tell you that they do not consider themselves Indian. They are not from India. So Native Americans, indigenous people, far more correct. Some people even say natives. Do not say, you know, people don't usually like Indians. When we're talking about names, Redskins, I'm embarrassed that we just now in 2020, it's maybe one thing, I think that happened in 2020, one positive thing in 2020, had a whole team named Redskins. Can you imagine us having groups like the San Francisco Black folks? I mean, that is just so derogatory. The San Francisco N-word actually is the way it would go. Other terms, hold down the fort, Indian giver, low on the totem pole. Totem pole is a religious symbol, okay? It's not something that we should be talking about and using at work. And then sitting Indian style. Now I think they're using crisscross applesauce, right? It's all about learning, guys. You know I'm about that. It's one big world. We can't know everything. All we need to do is continuously learn. So happy Indigenous Peoples Day, and let's continue to learn together. This is Randy B.